Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another video. Today I'm here in Bangkok standing in front of the Democratic Monument. I think that's what it's called. It looked beautiful, so I thought I'll shoot a video for you guys. I'm here for my Thailand immersion. We're gonna be starting Aden Koh Samui, Koh Phangan, be there for 8 days, do the immersion. So, but before I do that, in today's video, I wanted to talk to you guys about office game. How people in the office are creeping women out, how women have had it from men who hidden them. We're gonna get deeper into it, and then I'm gonna teach you how to properly talk to someone in your office. This is one of the most requested videos that I got on my Instagram request, which I asked people to share with me. Also, a lot of people, you know, who watch the channel, they are in office and they want to know how to not creep women out and also not sexually harass them. So let's begin today's video. Welcome back to the video, guys. Hi, my name is Kshitij. If you haven't subscribed yet, if you do not know who I am, my name is Kshitij and this is my channel, Iron Man Lifestyle. I teach you guys about dating advice, personal development, and how to develop your dream lifestyle. In today's video, we're going to be talking about office game. We're going to be talking about the ethics of office here in Thailand. We just had some vegan food, which was just, I'm going to add a photo of it somewhere down here. And it was just the kind of pasta that we had. And I got stunned the kind of food fucking yahan pe mil raha hai. So being a vegetarian, when you're here, these are the kind of shit that happen. Moving back, so there's this girl I was dating for a while, okay? And she was looking for a job during that time when she was looking for a job. So I asked her how's it going at your internship place and, you know, when you're going to get a job and all that stuff, okay? So during the time, she's like, every time I've gone to any office, the person who's like an intern, se leke a person who's like a partner, who's like a CEO, who's like the topmost person in the firm, everybody on that entire ladder has hit on me. Like everybody without fail. A person is a bachelor, he'll hit on her. A person has a girlfriend, he'll hit on her. A person has a wife, he'll hit on her. A person has a wife and has kids, he'll hit on her. A person has a wife and has kids and the kids have a wife and they have kids, he'll still hit on her. And it's just fucking crazy. It's crazy, alright? Like what we feel is that if I'm in office, there's a new intern here or there's like new employee, let's hit on her. Now, anytime someone hits on women in the office, we feel that women don't know what the fuck is up. But that's not true at all. Women have the most social intuition. They're connected to their emotions. They can feel their emotions much more than men. We're told not to cry. We're told not to, you know, do so many things. And men are more like, oh bro, kya chal raha? Oh bro, good chal raha. Or like surface level conversations happen whenever we're talking to any man. But women have those deeper conversations. They understand the vibe. It's like they always know what's up. So if you're talking to a girl and you're trying to hit on her, you're kind of making advances, then it's going to be a huge problem because she'll know that you are hitting on her. And then secondly, what's happening is, even though you're making advances on her, you're not even being clear with it. You're trying to be all safe and shit. And as I've spoken about in a number of my videos, I've been teaching you guys that confidence is all about owning up, which is one of the big reasons why a direct approach works so well. It's because a person can be confident and he owns up to his emotions. He sees a girl, goes up to the girl, tells her, hi, I think you're cute. Or notices whatever about the girl, something which is unique, and then has a conversation on that very genuinely. So it's genuine, it's authentic. But at the same time, when you do the same thing in office, you're trying to hide your emotion and you're trying to hidden the girl under the pretext of work, dude, she knows what's up. If you text a girl at night at 12 or like at 2 a.m. about work, or you comment on a story on Instagram, or you comment on a WhatsApp picture at 12 in the night or something, you tell her that, you know, I think you're cute, or that, you know, this is such a nice picture, you think that she doesn't know what's up. But that's not true. She knows what the fuck is up. And most of the time, the girl's gonna be polite. She's gonna be like, sir, thank you so much. Thank you so much for saying this to me. That's when the seniors ask the girl, are you coming to office tomorrow? How's work going? Okay, we should catch up. Helping out the girl, doing something for her, and then asking for a treat in return. All these are huge examples of supplication. So I'll just cover a bit of a supplication. What supplication means is that you're doing something for someone in return of like a favor. It's a very transactional thing. So like if I have a friend and I tell him that, bro, I'm going to help you out with this thing, but you got to do this in return, or I want to treat in return. That's sort of very transactional. So you're supplicating to the person. Mostly when it's a male-female dynamic, when you're talking to someone, you supplicate in the manner of, let's say, the most common examples are that I'm going to drop notes to your place. I'm going to recharge your phone. I'm going to buy you a drink. I'm going to, you know, send you a compliment, or be like, see, you remember I helped you out that day, so now I want to treat in return. All under the pretext that I want to meet you, I'm interested in you, and I'm attracted to you. Okay, not under the pretext that I genuinely want to help you. And anytime if it comes up as fake like that, it's going to be a huge fucking problem. So the number one thing you want to do is not supplicate. If you want to help a girl, you want to help a new intern in your office, a junior employee, come from a place of genuineness. All right, do not creep her the fuck out. These are creepy texts when you're married and stuff. Now, let's get back to the part about marriage. that married men hitting on women. It's sort of disgusting, okay? I believe that it's disgusting. You should not be doing it. Let's break it down, all right? Let's break it down. But at the end, you know, it's your life, your shit. You do whatever the fuck you want to do. Your morals and ethics will be decided by you. I'm just giving you my opinion. Coming back to the part of marriage. I believe that you should be getting married when you're ready to get married, okay? Most of the time, people in Asian countries, Southeast Asian countries, Indians mostly, and most of the people that get married, the main reason is they cannot get laid. They cannot get laid, they do not know how to talk to a girl, and they've been virgins all their life. So, for continuous sex and not going through the pain of going out and talking to people and developing this as a skill set, or developing the choice to get married to a girl of your choice, you'd be like, yeah, dad, you know, you did everything for me in my life. Okay, tumne paida kara humne, we were born, you cleaned us up, you taught us how to walk, you taught us how to ride the bicycle, you sent us to school, you sent us to college, you paid for everything. Everything that you've given to me is because of you. Now, the one last thing I want you to do is, help me find a girl, get married. That's the whole fucking agenda behind arranged marriage that fucking happens. And I do not agree with it at all. Go meet someone, okay? And even if you're meeting someone, you need to take up some time. You need to like be dating for like a year or two before you decide to lock down and make this huge decision, a huge commitment to be with that person for your entire life. It's just crazy how people can just jump into a decision of just getting married. Dude, like, look at me. I don't even jump into decisions of relationships. Fucking relationships, I think so much. I think to myself, that is there going to be compatibility? Do I like the girl? Is she fun to hang out with? How's the sex? Am I in the headspace that I want to be with the girl? Is she giving me space? Am I giving her space? Does she make me feel jealous? Am I a jealous fucking boyfriend? Am I needy? Am I in scarcity or abundance? So mostly, if you decide to get married, if you decide to get into a relationship, I would suggest you to get into that from a place of abundance. That I am enough who I am, I have everything that I want, I know I can get shit done, and I really like this girl is special. And not because she's the only girl that you can find. Which is why what happens is we don't know how to talk to girls, we just get an arranged marriage going. Now, once you get married, you don't know how to talk to a girl, so you don't know how to please her, you don't know what she likes and what she doesn't like. You've just been taught by movies that you just gotta be nice, which leads to no sexual tension, no fun, no chemistry in the relationship. And the girl, your wife, might start cheating on you. Or maybe you go get into a divorce because the sex is so bad. You haven't addressed the parts of your anxiety. Hello. Honey. Yeah. You haven't addressed the parts of your anxiety, the parts that come out when you're in a deep level relationship. So when you're in a relationship, you don't know how to please a girl. You don't know how to keep her happy. You're all clingy, needy because it's the first girl that you're dating. The first girl that you've, like, hopefully the first girl that you're getting married to. And then what happens is, after some time, God forbid, if you get divorced and then you're back on the fucking road, or if you know the kind of shit that's been happening everywhere is that you get married to a girl and then what she does is she puts a fucking false rape case on you and your family, and then you get divorced, she divorces you, she puts all that shit on you, and then now you're fucked. Okay, what do you do then? So now you're divorced, you're 40, you don't have the skill set to talk to girls, and now you find yourself in Bangkok like a sex tourist bargaining with fucking prostitutes.
Bargaining nahi hui. Oh shit. Didn't work out for the million sex tourists again, couldn't bargain. Aadat nahi chhutti bhai desiyon wali. Chhutti nahi hai. Paise kam karane hi karane hai.
More. Aur aa gaye. Demand bahut zyada hai. Demand is fucking hitting the roof here. India is sending so much fucking tourism here, demand is...
What the fuck is that? Guys, sort out your fucking shitty life. And then, so, you've had no experience with women, you were a virgin, you didn't come out of abundance, you got married to a girl, okay, who you absolutely loved, you decided, okay, I'm not saying I decided, you fucking decided to be monogamous, you fucking decided to get married to the girl, you fucking decided that you're gonna be with one woman your entire life and not hit on other people. That was the commitment you made. But now you're gonna go in office with your shitty angry mood from your work stress, or with your normal life, or with your sex life, your relationship life, or just in general, because you haven't done the inner work as well. You're not spiritual, you're not working on yourself, you don't know what your issues are, what triggers are, and then you just seem to not get along with a lot of people, and even the relationship that you have with your wife, the married relationship, you feel it's just all drama, we keep fighting all the time, and it's just crazy, okay? Then, when you're in office, you see that new girl, the young girl, okay? Also, yeah, now your wife is getting old, and you're like, oh my god, my wife's getting old, I want to go with a girl who's, you know, more youthful, more charming, who's more feminine. So now, a new girl comes in office, and you want to hit on her, okay? I understand you want to do that, but had you just addressed, like, if you just addressed before getting married the part of beauty, that beauty is just very superficial. You date people around and then you realize that you want more of an emotional connection, and then you decide to get married to someone who's relatively beautiful. She's cute, all right, you can keep that in mind, but when you're looking for like a serious thing, it's not all about the way she's looking, because beauty is going to fade away. It's about the connection and stuff. And then when you get married, you're going to be coming from a holistic place. And if you want to be monogamous, it will be much easier for you to be. And then you will not be distracted by those girls in office, the youthful ones. So now you're in office, you're getting distracted by the youthful girl. Your relationship at home is going to shit and you start hitting her now. And she's in her 20s, dude. She's dating around. She knows, all right? She's dating someone like me. She's going to come up to me and be like, dude, these fucking uncles are so fucking weird and creepy. What the fuck do I do? They keep hitting on me all the time. And then, you know, we're going to be ending up having sex. Not fucking you, all right? At the same time, that's going to happen. There's a proper right way to do that. And we'll cover that right now. So, if you're married, stay in your relationship, get that working out. Or get divorced, get this area of your life sorted if your relationship is not working out. Or if you're divorced, start going out. Start going out, start doing shit, get this handled. And then, like, of course, you know, you can hit on people at your workplace as well. Let's cover that now. So now, how do you talk to women in your office so that you're not labeled as a creep, a weirdo, and a fucking horny dude? This is what you do. Firstly, you gotta change your entire demeanor in office, man. You cannot be the quiet guy. I mean, you can be the quiet guy, but then you cannot expect yourself to go up to women and then be like, you know, let's talk about work and for them to believe you. So what you do, okay, we're gonna cover two things. We're gonna cover active attraction and we're gonna cover passive attraction. Both these things are huge in any social interaction, in any social situation that you're in, any social place that you're in. All right, firstly, what I'm saying is, when you're in office, make sure you talk to everybody, not just the girls, the boys. Whenever you talk to someone, you bring value in the way you talk. Most of the value is humor, fun that you're bringing, jokes that you're cracking with people, and coming with a great energy, all right? So come with a great energy, be very certain, crack jokes. You've got to do that. If you want to learn in depth how to, you know, do all these things, you're going to learn how to not run out of things to say, you're going to learn what to talk about, couple of things. If you want more deeper coaching, there's a mentorship program. I'm going to add a link to it out here, all right? So now, you bring in value, you be fun, you be charming with everyone around, and you want to be seen as the center of attention. Second thing. So be seen as the center of attention, and anytime somebody sees you as the center of attention, they're going to be passively attracted. So let's say I'm in office. I've never been to office, but then in my college, I saw that. So I was the one who was the most talkative guy, and I was very well connected with a lot of people. I'd go talk to people. Other people would see me talking to them. So anytime I'd be getting introduced to anyone else through my friends, or just go up to someone and be like, hey, how's it going? Or just have like a more organic conversation with someone, they'd always be intrigued because they've seen me around so many times and they're already intrigued that, who am I? What the fuck do I do? Why am I always surrounded with people? Why am I always, you know, loud and my shor macha raha? Why is that? So in the first part, just add this as well. You know, your voice is important. You got to be loud. You cannot be thinking that people are going to be listening to me. What do I do? So be loud. Be certain with what you're doing. I've covered all these things in a different video as well. You can check that out for more deeper stuff. And I made a mentorship to it. So you got to be loud. You got to be fun. Okay. You have to be fun and you have to be very certain and charming. That's going to bring a lot of value. Secondly, be seen as the center of attention. It's going to generate passive attraction. Then thirdly, anytime you go up and talk to someone, try to stay away from direct approaches. In the social environment, you do not do direct approaches. What you do is, you go up to someone and you have a very genuine conversation. Let's give you an example. Let's say I'm standing in line for food, all right, and there's a girl right next to me. Maybe, you know, she's got something on her plate. I'm going to be like, what is it that you're eating? Meat? Oh my God, no. I'm a vegetarian. I love dogs. Do you love animals? Okay, why do you eat meat? Okay, I'm sorry. I'm just kidding. I love dogs. Okay, tell me this. Are you a cat person? Are you a dog person? You're a dog person. Really, how many dogs do you have? Are they stray? What breed are they? Dude, that's so amazing. You know, you should make your dogs meet my dogs. They're going to go on a date. You have like a female dog, like bitch. You do? Okay, that's going to be amazing. I have three dogs. You know, maybe they can have some shit going. She can choose. It could be like doggies ka swayamvar or something like that. So when you start a conversation like that and you go from one thing to the other, it's going to be amazing. So I can go on and on about this stuff. So this is about not running out of things to say. In this video, I'm going to be teaching you the basic vibe and, you know, the strategy behind it, how you got to be speaking to people in office, how you got to be talking to people in office, and how you just have to generally be in office. So once you can start a conversation like that, you can be fun. You can have all those things. Do not restrict yourself to just one person or only to girls. Have friends in office, hang out with them. And then generally, when you have a group in office, you can make plans after office as well to go somewhere. Or you could be just like talking to a girl and everything, and then you can talk about something, get connected over something, right? So let's say in this example, it's about being a vegan or it's about having dogs. So in this example, a perfect idea for a date would be going to a vegan restaurant or would be going to a dog cafe where she brings the dogs, I bring my dog. All right, that's going to be perfect. It's not even going to look like that you're hitting on her. At the same time, she's going to be wishing that I hope he's hitting on me. At the same time, there's going to be mystery created. The girl would be thinking that, does this person really like me? Or is he just talking to me because he's just nice and sweet to everyone? And is this just like a casual friends kind of date? And she'd want you to like her because, you know, passive attraction. It's already there. You're the popular guy. Okay. And then simply you can go on a date there. So So now, actionable tips, as I just covered already in the starting of the video, do not supplicate, alright? Do not supplicate. Do not go under the pretext of work. Keep the conversation fun, which I just taught you. Keep the conversation fun, happening. Go from one topic to another. Keep it lighthearted. Be seen as connecting with people. Be certain with what you say. Be confident about it. Have a loud voice. At the same time, then organically set up a date. Or maybe, you know, in the first time when you see a girl, when you meet a girl, when you're talking to her, do not set up a date. Just talk about stuff and then tease. And then be like, you know, we should go there sometime. Let's exchange Instagrams or something, all right? So then you can exchange an Instagram or you can get a number. At the same time, I would say exchanging Instagram or a number on the second meeting. Do not do that on the first meeting in a social environment. Very simple difference between cold approach, where we tell you to close and get the number the same day, the same time you're talking to a girl, versus in social environments, is very simple. In cold approach, where you're walking on the road or you're in a club or during day game, it's called cold approach because you don't know the person at all. It's a cold approach, no connection at all. So since you don't know that person at all, you're not going to see that person again. So whatever you have, the time, abhi hai bas. Everything is right now. You got to get the number right now. Now, when you're in a social environment, when you're talking to someone, you're going to be seeing that person again. So there's no need for you to be desperate, or there's no need for you to fuck up your social value there and look desperate or look creepy that I'm only here for an agenda and I want your number. Just be the social guy. You're going to see the girl again. Believe in yourself. And then next time when you see her, then you have an organic interaction, and then organically you set up a date. And then you can get it, go on a date, maybe be girlfriend with her, or maybe see how that's going. If you're going to be confident as fuck, every girl would want to talk to you. Alright, but then I hope if you want to get married, then stick with one girl. Baki tumhare ethics hain jo bhi hain. That's going to be all from my side, guys. I hope I covered a lot of shit in the video. I want these videos to be very in-depth. That's what I try to keep here. Firstly, giving you the psychology of the problem, then giving you the psychology of you, how it's been going, and then giving you actionable tips in the end. How? Okay, the what, why, how, everything, just covering everything so that you get a deep knowledge, a deep insight into my thinking, into the things that I do, the things that I say. And also at the same time, once you cover that part of where it's coming from, a lot of the how you need to do it and what you need to do gets sorted apne aap hi. Alright, so that's going to be all from my side, boys. I hope you liked the video. If you liked it, just leave a thumbs up, leave a comment below what you want me to talk about next. At the same time, if you're not subscribed yet, I've been making these videos, hit the subscribe button, guys. Slank it, smash it, demolish it. I'm going to see you in the next video. It's going to be all from my side, boys. Solo. Peace from Bangkok.